नमस्ते, वेलकम टू बीटीयू ई शिक्षण प्रोग्राम। आई डॉक्टर दाक्षायणी आर पाटिल, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर एट बीएमएस कॉलेज ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर, बुल टेम्पल रोड, बैंगलोर, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू वंस अगेन टू जॉइन मी ऑन दिस सेशन फॉर द कोर्स टाइटल्ड बिल्डिंग सर्विसेज 3, 18 ARC 63 फॉर द बिहार 6th सेमिस्टर कोर्स, द सेशन इवन सेमिस्टर ऑफ 2021। So this is under the provisions of BTU e-learning center. So I have been handling module 1 and 2 so far. Module 1 completed, that is mechanical ventilation and air conditioning introduction. We are currently underway with the air conditioning systems under module 2. So module 2, this one is the lecture number 7, and we have started the types under the types of air conditioning system. We completed unitary type. We are proceeding with the central air conditioning systems. So under that we have done last session, we just started it off, and now we are proceeding with understanding single zone, multiple zones, dual duct systems, VAV systems, central AC systems, two types. So let us begin with single zone central systems. So under the central air conditioning, as the word nomenclature says, the equipment of the AC is centrally located. So it's a central equipment which caters to the different parts of the building. It is the air conditioning which provides for the largest scale of building space possible. So all this while we have seen different systems, unitary systems. We are proceeding with the central AC. Now with respect to the working fluid that is used in a system, air conditioning also depends on the fundamental principles of refrigeration cycle. So air, water are two fluids that are used or applied in any such refrigeration cycle. They are called as a working fluids, enabling the whole process of refrigeration and air conditioning. So depending on this, we have three types of system possibilities to produce the required heating. One, all air system, all water system, which is called as hydronic system, air-water systems combination. So either we adopt only air in a system, only water in a system, or we use both of them for the functioning of the system. So under single zone central AC system, the definition goes, the centralized single zone catering to a single room or group of rooms, which is called as a zone. Either unitary or central systems can be applied in this case. So when we are catering to a single room, we normally adopt unitary system. For example, window AC, split AC, package AC. So now in this particular section, we will look at central air conditioning system, which is all air single zone system. So we will begin with this component ahead. Now a central unit which is called as air handling unit, popularly very commonly referred as AHU, is adopted or provided in a central AC system. It cools or heats the air as per the requirement, as per the climatic conditions, as per the season. Conditioned air is distributed to one or more or a group of rooms which we will call as single zone. Now, single zone refers to group of spaces which have similar requirement of cooling load. That is, they might be producing heat in the space or gaining heat in the space to a very common range. So we pool them together as a zone and decide that we will provide the similar capacity air conditioning to the system, single zone. Now let us look at a schematic of a single zone central AC system, okay, the arrangement of such a system. Now what do we have here? When you look at the rectangular component where my cursor is moving right now, so that is the AHU, air handling unit, where we have the air filter to the left side, and air filter followed by a preheat coil or cooling coil, right? And then we have the reheat coil, fan, supply air. So from the left side, we are getting the exhaust air, that is a used air, return air, which is entering the system. We mix in outside air with the return air and pass it through the evaporative coil and through the circle of the refrigeration cycle, and then it is supplied to all the other rooms, room 1, room 2 and so forth. So that is the typical arrangement of a single zone central AC system. Now we will understand it step by step, component wise. So we will number them sequentially. So we have number 1, supply air fan. Supply air fan, which is marked to the right side. It is used or provided to distribute air through the unit, ductwork included, and air distribution devices to the respective rooms. So supply air fan basically handles the final output, that is the cooled, cleaned, dehumidified air. Okay, and it has to supply it through the unit, through the ductwork, to the terminal end. That is, terminal is the air device at the end of the cycle where the cool air is entering the room. So that comprises of supply air zone, and there is a supply air fan here which is creating the required suction power. Then we have the second one, the cooling coil or the evaporator, both synonymously used. So it is used or provided to cool and dehumidify the air in summertime. Receives chilled water or refrigerant from a remote refrigeration unit. So cooling coil is normally at the interface between the unit and the room to be cooled, or the hot air that has to be cooled. So hot air is going to enter firstly the evaporator, where all the processes initiate. Then we have number 3, the reheat coil. Partially reheats the cooled air when the room heat gain is less than the maximum. Provides humidity control during the summer times. So that is the heating or reheat coil which is provided, which can be provided to reheat the cooled air. If the thermostat senses that the room heat gain is not so much, it is less than the expected or the maximum. The number 4, return air fan. So it takes the air from the rooms and distributes it through the return ducts to the AC plant that is located outside. Okay, so the function of return air fan to collect the air from the rooms. This air is hot and not clean, and also latent heat is there, so dehumidifying is required. It takes the air from the rooms and distributes it through the return air ducts. So return air ducts are shown here as a single line to the AC plant outside. In small systems with little or no return air ducts, return air fan is not required because supply fan can be used to draw the return air as well. So we will not adopt this in smaller scaled requirements. Smaller scaled HVAC systems, you can eliminate the return air fan and use the supply air fan to initiate the suction process of the used air as well. Number 5, we have the preheat coil. Preheat coil. Now this is an essential requirement in colder climates. So below freezing degree temperatures, and it is used to temper the air, to prop up the air so that the chilled water cooling coils cannot freeze up or do not freeze up. So to avoid the freezing of the cooling coils during extreme freezing temperatures, we need to adopt the preheat coil. It is optional in other climates. We can skip it, not required in the hotter climates. And we may locate it in the outside air or mixed air stream as well. So ideal location would be at the end point where the outside air is getting mixed with the return air and just before the cooling coil. Number 6, the filtration system for the entire AC system, where we use the right kind of filters to clean the used air. So the function of filters is to arrest the impurities that are embedded or dispersed in the air. Number 7, bypassing air. Now around the evaporator provides another method of controlling the humidity. So we have the bypass air running circulated around the evaporator, which provides another method of controlling the humidity in the air. But the efficiency compared to the reheat coil in controlling the humidity is limited. So that is our bypass damper. Now dampers are the small controlled openings which will control the amount of air that is supposed to pass through them and moves it on to the next component. So before the bypassing air is crossing the cooling coil, we have the dampers which can be regulated, shut off when it not required, or regulate the opening size to let in the required quantity of air. This is all metered and monitored. That's number 7. Now other components of a single zone central system. One is the room thermostat. A room thermostat controls the evaporator capacity to maintain the desired room temperature. Right? So a room thermostat controls the evaporator capacity to maintain the required room temperature in response to the prevailing outdoor conditions and indoor heat gain. So they may come as knobs or digital display, manual operation, remote control. A room humidistat, which controls room humidity. This is also kind of a thermostat which controls the humidity of the air, room air. right? So going ahead, now we will look at multi-zone central systems. So multi-zone refers to more than one zone in the building, with each zone having its own requirement of cooling load. So the heat gain and the heat output, heat load varies across these zones, and how to control this at a central point. Now under multiple zone and all air units, because currently right now we are in process of looking at all air systems only. Ahead we will look at water and air water systems. So under multiple zone and all air units, we will have four basic types or four broad classifications of multiple zone all air systems, and they are called as reheat system, multi-zone system, dual duct system, and variable air volume system. Okay, four basic types under multiple zone all air units: reheat system, multi-zone system, dual duct system, and VAV, variable air volume system. Kindly connect that VAV system. So under the multiple zone all air units, we have constant air volume type, CAV, popularly known as CAV systems. We will include, or it will include, reheat system, multi-zone system, dual duct system. So when the air quantity delivered to the rooms or zones does not vary, unlike the variable air volume system. So there are two possibilities: constant air volume supply or variable air volume supply, which we have seen in the last class. So constant air volume type will include reheat system, multi-zone, and dual duct. So the air volume is constant. Is it a constant volume and parameters when it is sent to each zone? So similarly, now air handling unit is that component which is a sort of mandatory in a central AC system. Air handling units, which are the interface between the AC plant room and the air space to be conditioned. And this air handling unit in a multi-zone system will have two coils mainly: heating coil and cooling coil, which is also called as hot deck or cold deck. So what do we see here? We have a heating coil, we have a mixing damper. So hot deck is on the top section, cold deck is here. The cold deck will have the evaporator coil, which is a cooling coil. So air enters, mixing dampers to mix the two, heating coil for a hot deck, the fans, the filters to create the suction power. Now in multi-zone units, the ducts are arranged in a typical manner. So there are different zones. Now we are calling it multi-zone, so that means more than one zone. So in this case, let us presume we have four zones, so 1, 2, 3, 4. So from the multi-zone AC unit, separate duct systems are provided which reach each zone separately. So separate ducts from each set of dampers to each zone. So dampers are going to control the air flow and air quantity. Cold and hot air are mixed in varying proportions by the dampers according to the zone requirements. So that can be calibrated. The proportion of air crossing the dampers can be calibrated as per the zone requirement and demand. So the ducts are branching out from the hot deck on top, cold deck on top, bottom. You see that line? So you have a duct branching from the hot deck, branching from the cold deck, then they move to the individual zone. So damper is going to control, that is the interface from which the damper is sieve merging out. Alright. So the advantage of multi-zone system, it provides good zone temperature control. Each zone can be very well controlled with respect to the air parameters such as temperature. So you can modulate the temperature in a better manner. Humidity control may not be as satisfactory in applications with high proportions of outside air. So that is the limitation. Humidity control may not be satisfactory in applications which encounter high proportions of outside air merging into the system. Each air handling unit is limited to about 12 to 14 zones. So kindly remember this as a thumb rule ahead. So you can use one AHU, air handling unit, which is housed in a room called as AHU room. Otherwise, it is called as a fan coil unit. So each air handling unit can be providing to 12 to 14 zones max, catering to. It is inexpensive system for small and medium sized applications where few separate zones are desired and humidity conditions are not so much critical, because we know that humidity control is one of the limitations of the system as it is not as satisfactory. So we can use this comfortably in small and medium sized applications where few separate zones can be desired and humidity conditions are not so critical. So this was a brief lecture up to then. So next lecture, number 8, what we will do is we will look at dual duct systems, that means two duct system, variable air volume system. What we saw was constant air volume in this lecture. And we have been seeing all air systems so far. A system that uses only air to enable the heating cooling processes. So ahead we will look at possibility of all water system, or which is called as hydronic system, and combination system, that is air water systems. Alright, so we will come back to the lecture 8 ahead. So thank you and see you there.